I love the detective work, and it you often get a result, which I like as well. And I love spending time over, you know, because that's the question we get a lot, so we can spend a lot of time just poring over it and having a look, and can discover a lot about Rockhampton and its development through it. And the reason I love it, one, it's old information, so you can see people's handwriting, but more importantly, it's the hunt for information and the detective, the mystery of it. So someone will come and ask, you know, well, where did my relative live? Or, you know, I've got this address, or they were in Rockhampton. So going to the maps and then discovering where their house was and then going through the rates books, it is like being a detective. At the end of it, that feeling of, wow, you know, I've found the information and it's solved the mystery. So I think that's why I like it. It's a bit of detective work and you know, someone gets information out of it. Yeah. His name is Lewis Marcellin Martin, but he actually went by Marcellin Lewis Martin. He changed his name. He was a Frenchman who came in the 1860s when a lot of people came to Rockhampton looking for work and opportunities. And he must have had a funny sense of humour or something like that, because he made a lot of comments on the business people and the people who were, you know, well-to-do and all that in the area. So what this book has is actually the bound copies of his magazine that he set up in 1881 and 1882, called The Laughing Jackass. What I got out of it was that even back then, people were having a go at the establishment. So it's not a new thing. I love the 1980s and the satire that came out of that with our politicians. So I guess that's why it resonated with me, is that I could see even 100 or so years ago that, you know, someone still could do that. Because you think, like, looking at photos, everyone looks so prim and proper. And that was the technology of the day, that they couldn't move and that sort of thing. So actually seeing someone's drawings can sort of show that, no, they had thoughts and feelings very similar to what we have today. We've actually been doing a digitisation project for it, so it makes them more accessible, and it also protects the negatives. And as we were going through, we found a picture, several pictures actually, of a naked older gentleman, which we were quite surprised, because all the photos had been quite formal 1930s, 1950s, you know, photos, passport photos, in a studio mostly. So, you know, we're just coming across that, and then my colleague one day picked it up, put it on the light box, and went, "What's this?" and sort of pulled it all over to sort of say, "What's this?" And we just don't expect that from a studio. Certainly, that's the thing I love about history, is that it can surprise you when you have an assumption of times. Sometimes it can come across and say, "No, don't assume." I think Rockhampton hasn't changed in a way in its history and its modern day. There are still quite a lot of issues that are still here, like flooding. And again, knowing the history, can understand why Rockhampton was built right here. But the impression I get of those in Rockhampton is, if there's a job to be done, they'll just go in and do it. Which, coming from a city, I quite actually appreciate.